The legal challenges are set to begin as Mongrel Mob members lawyer up against the government's proposed anti-gang laws. The legislation would see gang patches banned and police given extra powers to stop gang members from congregating. Criminal lawyer Arama Ngapo has been hired by members of the Mongrel Mob to test the legality of proposed laws, and she joins us now from Tokoroa. Arama, thanks so much for your time this morning. We spoke to you last time about the idea that gang members might be forced to wear facial makeup to cover up facial tattoos. That idea seems to have been dropped, but there is still a threat, right, with this proposal that gang members would not be allowed to wear gang patches in public.
Kia ora and atamari, Anna, thanks for inviting me along. And that's right. Essentially, this is a human rights issue and it's a Bill of Rights issue, and it needs to be considered by all of New Zealand, not just a particular group. What the government's trying to do is breach people's ability for freedom of movement, peaceful association, freedom of expression, freedom from discrimination. And I think all New Zealanders should be concerned about that particular type of imposition of legislation.
When we talk about it being a gang patch ban, and you talk about it being a human rights issue or a freedom of expression issue, how far do those two circles in the Venn diagram cross over, I guess? Does it come down to a sports uniform? How on earth are they going to define the parameters of this?
Well, the second part to this argument is that the legislation already exists for the police and for particular and for the criminal court to take a lot of these issues that they're trying to address into account. Now, not to give a legal a seminar on it, but we already have the prohibition of gangs legislation, gang insignia legislation, that already prohibits and restricts the wearing of gangs in government departments. So we don't need to re-legislate that. We already have Section 9 of the Sentencing Act that already says judges can take into account aggravating factors such as being part of organised crime.
When you talk about that, though, that is post a crime being committed and a conviction being secured. And I presume that the reason, and I am making a presumption here, the reason for this proposed legislation is that National or the government is going to say, well, there will be police out there stopping the crime before it happens.
I don't think there's any police officer in New Zealand that would say they have the ability of that much foresight. I also think that if Minister Mitchell actually listened to what frontline police staff are saying, they are saying that this legislation won't work and it won't make us safer. And that's the whole premise that Minister Mitchell said. He sent a letter to the Commission of Police, Andrew Costa, in December last year and said every New Zealander deserves to feel safe. Well, the Opotiki police officers have already said that this legislation won't work. In Tokoroa, where I'm from, in the South Waikato, that's not going to make me or my community feel any safer. We want the government to look at the real issues that are affecting our communities, not just to demonise a particular part of our community, the gang community. We want them to address poverty, social issues, underlying issues that actually led to the creation of gangs.
When we look at the government's arguments for this, and you've just outlined some very good arguments in favour of funding programs that will reduce crime in a manner of ways, the government says this is simply another one of those tools. And I'm playing devil's advocate, they'll say, but we are going to put money into those things and this is just another tool. Gangs are a major contributor of crime. This is one of the tools in the toolkit.
If you go along to any district court today or on any criminal court list, you're going to see a lot of people that have no association with gangs appearing in court that commit crime. And there are very serious criminal offenders in New Zealand and none of them have gang associations.
When we look at, under your instructions that you've got from your client so far, I presume that this is going to be any legislation is going to be lengthy, costly. How far are your clients willing to go in fighting proposed legislation on a ban?
Well, the whole point is that what I said at the beginning, this is the New Zealand Bill of Rights issue, and that has to concern all of us. The second point I'd make is that Judith Collins currently has the brief to look at this legislation and see whether or not it is going to work. And the whole issue is that we haven't seen the legislation. And the way that the coalition government is going with pushing legislation through with absolutely no consultation, the chief science advisor for the prime minister says this will not work. It is a multifaceted issue that requires in-depth analysis. And so, you know, is this just another example of the coalition government passing through legislation when the experts have clearly said this will not make us feel safer, this will not address the issue? Tiaka whai order, gone. One reading in the House, two reading in the House, three reading in the House, completely scrapped. The government had advice that that was not a positive thing to do. They have advice that this legislation is not positive. They're simply not listening.
You must then be concerned that it is going to go through and that the legal battle will actually occur on the other side once the legislation is in play.
And the extremely hypocritical issue here is that Minister Mitchell a day ago said that this particular legislation is going to go to a full parliamentary committee for consideration. And so I have to sit here as a lawyer and wonder why the Tiaka Whai or the scrapping of the Māori Health Authority was done under urgency, no ability to make submissions. But on this legislation, if what he says is correct, he's going to put that through to his parliamentary committee for a select committee for consultation. It just absolutely makes no sense and it is hypocrisy.
Arama Ngapo, thank you so much for joining us this morning. No doubt we will be catching up with you again.
Namahi.